Hello and welcome to the second part of the unit Hydrogen Production from Fossil Fuels. In this unit, we will cover the hydrogen production methods from coal, petroleum and alcohols. We will start talking about the different processes to obtain hydrogen from coal. Coal is an organic sediment and it was initially formed by the decomposition of plant matter from swamps or river delta, among others. Subsequently, these sediments were covered by sludge, and with the passage of the time, an increase in pressure and temperature, the molecular structure was altered until carbonization occurs. The first method shown here is the steam gasification, where two consecutive chemical processes take place. The first one is a pyrolysis reaction, which is very fast. The pyrolysis processes consist of the decomposition of a solid fuel by the action of heat, normally around 1200 degrees Celsius for the case of coal, and in the absence of an oxidizing medium. Afterwards, there is a slow conversion of residual organic solids where water vapor is required at between 600 and 1000 degrees Celsius. The conditions normally used are temperatures up to 2000 degrees Celsius and pressure up to 3 megapascal. It is important to know the characteristic of the coal to be gasified in order to know the economic cost. The geologically older the coal, the lower its reactivity and therefore the higher the temperature it requires. The main disadvantages of this process are that solid materials have to be handled, which is more difficult and expensive than handling liquids or gases, and that large amounts of CO2, SO2 and ash are produced. The option of integrating the gasification process with the combined heat and power cycle is considered to be the cleanest and most efficient method of burning coal and obtaining electricity. In the thermal cracking, coal is introduced into a thermal cracker where it is broken down into black coal and hydrogen as a fuel byproduct. This process allows the extraction of hydrogen without producing CO2, and it is expected to be highly competitive in the near future compared to other processes. The last process shown here is the production of coke. Modern coke ovens produce about 350 cubic meters of gas from 1 ton of coal. Half of this gas is used to operate the furnace at temperature above 1000 degrees Celsius, and the remaining half is processed to extract hydrogen using low temperature condensation or absorption. The products obtained, in addition to coke, are hydrogen, around 55% in volume, methane, around 25% in volume, and liquid such as light oils, ammonia or ammonia compounds, and tars. It is estimated that about 60 billion of normal cubic meter of hydrogen could be obtained from coke production. Hydrogen production from coal using gasification is a well-established technology. Globally, there are around 130 coal gasification plants in operation, and more than 80% of which are in China. Hydrogen production using coal produces CO2 emission of about 19 tons of CO2 per tons of hydrogen, which is twice as much as natural gas. The high CO2 emission intensity of coal-based hydrogen means that carbon capture technology will need to be used if hydrogen from coal is to have a future in a low carbon energy system. In the graph, we can see the hydrogen production cost in China, where CAPEX requirements account for around 50% of the cost of producing hydrogen from coal, and fuel accounts for a further 15-20%. The availability and cost of coal therefore plays an important role in determining the viability of coal-based hydrogen projects. Reducing the carbon footprint will be a critical factor for the prospects of coal-based hydrogen in a low-carbon context. Adding carbon capture technology to coal-based hydrogen production is expected to increase CAPEX and fuel cost by 5% and OPEX by 30%. However, carbon capture technology will enable a CO2 intensity as low as 2 kilograms of carbon dioxide per kilogram of hydrogen. Now, we will explain how hydrogen can be formed from petroleum. Petroleum is formed from terrestrial plants, marine plants, and animals, which are in a marine environment, deposited and buried 106 years and deep between 1 and 4 kilometers. Marine plants and animals have a higher content of nitrogenous and sulfurous compounds, and therefore petroleum can have a higher proportion of this element compared to the ones that have coal and natural gas. The processes to which petroleum can go through in order to get hydrogen are partial oxidation and hydrocracking. The partial oxidation of heavy oils, particularly the remains of petroleum distillation, is one of the most widespread methods for the production of hydrogen. This process consists of the conversion of steam, oxygen and hydrocarbons into hydrogen and carbon oxides with or without catalyst. The appropriate catalytic process for light hydrocarbon is produced at about 590 degrees Celsius, and the non-catalytic process can also be used with heavy oils and coal. They work at temperature of around 1150 and 1315 degrees Celsius, and the pressures are between 1 to 10 megapascals. Partial oxidation provides the energy for steam displacement. The resulting synthesis gas can be used either for methanol synthesis or for catalytic conversion to increase hydrogen production. On the other hand, hydrocracking plants are used to convert heavy oils into light oils and gasoline. This process requires an input of hydrogen and heat, where the first one can be supplied by naphtha. Hydrocracking usually involves a preparation of the materials with hydrotreatment to remove metals, sulfur, nitrogen and oxygen. The conversion process of heavy oils is carried out in several states of hydrocracking at high pressure using catalysts and temperatures in the range of 320 and 400 degrees Celsius. The partial oxidation of heavy oils is usually used in large installations. The gaseous product, CO and hydrogen, at temperatures of about 1200 and 1350 degrees Celsius, and they are cooled and undergo to a displacement reaction to obtain pure hydrogen. The last method to produce hydrogen from fossil fuels is the production from alcohols. Methanol can be endothermically cracked using catalysts to produce a synthesis gas plus traces of methanol, ether and methane. A two-stage membrane separation system extracts hydrogen from the CO-rich fuel, which is burned in the cracker. The catalytic decomposition of methanol with steam reforming takes place in ethanol fuel cells at temperature higher than 250 degrees Celsius. Photocatalytic methods can also be used to break down methanol. As for the ethanol, we can say that ethanol is a very promising source of hydrogen, as it is a renewable source when obtained from biomass. Therefore, catalytic reforming with steam is of increasing interest. This reaction has been widely studied using catalysts based on nickel, copper, cobalt and noble metals. The reaction is highly endothermic and requires high temperature, usually above 600 degrees Celsius. At these temperatures, the ethanol is reformed into a mixture of hydrogen and CO2, and it is necessary to go through a second reforming stage to increase hydrogen production and eliminate CO2. Thank you for your attention.